Hi, in today's tutorial, we're going to talk about how to use generative AI to design Chinese New Year greeting cards with Midjourney, Google Bard, and of course ChatGPT. Let's go! If you haven't gotten yourself a Midjourney account, you can click join the beta and sign up for the account. If not, you can just sign in and then go to Discord. There will be a Midjourney channel. And this is where we create our Chinese New Year greeting card designs. So let's start with the most basic one. We just type slash imagine and then followed by a prompt. So if I want a Chinese New Year greeting card design with a flying dragon, so I can say ancient Chinese drawing style with a dragon flying in the sky. And then it will show us that our request has been put into the system and now waiting to start. As you are watching this video, everything that I've shown you here, I have put it in 5x or 10x speed so that you don't waste your time watching my computer render the design. So if not, you will be thinking like, hey, why is it running so fast on Dr. Lau's machine? But when I'm using it, it's going so slow. Do I need to buy a new computer or laptops? No, that's not the case, all right? Okay, so it's now 93%. You can click into it once it has completely rendered. So you can see that Midjourney is still pretty okay. The details is very fine and it captures all the things that you need. And now there are 8 buttons here. U1, U2, U3, U4 if you want to use any of the designs. So on the top left is number 1, on the bottom right is number 4. And V1, V2, V3, V4 is if you want to choose any of the design, but you want it to generate more variations. And that's what the V stands for. And this is a reset or regenerate buttons. And if you click this, it will draw another set of photos or images for you. Now let's try another one. And now I want to have a family celebrating Chinese New Year on the moon and then anime style. Now while waiting, you can also scroll up to look at pictures that other people have generated, and that's just like the pictures that you generated yourself. You can just click into any of them, and if you like it, right, you can just open in browser. Okay, right click and save image as. So this way you don't have to waste any of the credits or computation time just to wait for the image. And especially if you are using it for Facebook or WhatsApp, the resolution, the details of the pictures is more than enough. Okay, now our second set of images is generated completely. And let's take a look at it. So this is a family celebrating Chinese New Year on the moon, and this is an anime style. So you can see very clearly it's like those Japanese style, manga style, very nice. So you can just open it in the browser, right click and save image as to keep it. Okay, so this is one way of doing it. Or if you want to have, let's say you like this one, the bottom right number 4, and you want to have more variations of it, just click V4. Okay. And then you tell you that currently making variations for image number 4 and waiting to start. Okay, and click into it. Now you can see these 4 are pretty much the same style, but the compositions and the number of family members are different, but they are definitely the same style, right? So open in browser, right click and save image. So this is pretty much how Midjourney works. Now, in case you were thinking like, maybe I don't want to spend so much money, or I just want to try it out and play with it and see how it goes, you can also use another alternative called Google Bard. So go to bard.google.com. The latest version allows us to create image as well. So you can say, create an image of Chinese New Year. Now Google Bard is relatively new in image generation. So I wouldn't give a prompt that is too complex or has a lot of requirements because it won't be able to do well. And you can see, so here's an image of Chinese New Year. Without saying anything, it just gives me two images of girls in Chinese New Year. You can see the details of the faces are distorted. Yeah, it's new player. Okay, so just be a bit lenient. So you can click generate more and see. And now it shows you a picture of bun. It's not even Chinese dumplings, where some places they eat it during Chinese New Year. Okay, anyway, if you like one of the images, let's say this one, just click it and then click the download full size button. Okay, and you'll get the image downloaded. Alright, so this is Google Bard, and it's just a new tool, and it has a lot of room for improvement, so nothing to brag about. When we talk about AI and generative AI in particular, we must remember our old friend ChatGPT. The latest ChatGPT 4 comes with the image generation feature, but you don't want to do it in the main window. Instead, we should go to Explore GPTs and go to DALL-E, because this is a special tool that's dedicated for image generation. But in fact, the engine is the same. The only difference is DALL-E will generate two images every time, where if you do it in the main window, it will only generate one. So let's try something else. Say draw an image of ancient Chinese people celebrating Chinese New Year in Kuala Lumpur. I like to give some random prompts like this just to test the limit and boundaries of AI tools. And let's see how it turns out. Okay, so it looks okay. Let's zoom in and see. So this is ancient Chinese people celebrating Chinese New Year. And you can see on the far end, there's some city look, and then same goes to this one. So not too bad. I'm quite happy with that. Okay, let's try one more. Now this time we want to have a cartoon style, more westernized and not the anime or manga style. So I can say, draw an image of a group of animals celebrating Chinese New Year using Pixar cartoon style. And let's zoom in. I'm quite happy with the results. You get the animals, you got dragons, you got tiger, monkey, a mouse here, and pandas of course. And then the second image also, because I use Pixar cartoon style, and you can see a lot of the fine details are rendered very well here. So I'm very happy with that. Now ChatGPT 4 is also a paid service. If you want to use the free alternative, go to Bing Image Creator. They use the same engine, DALL-E. So you can type your prompt here and click create to generate the similar pictures using the same engine. Now I won't give you any further demo on this, I'll leave it to you to give it a try. Alright, that's all for today. I hope you have learned something new in this tutorial, and promise me, no more boring flowers, firecrackers, pictures, and just go ahead and generate some cool Chinese New Year pictures. Impress your friends and families in the WhatsApp group, alright? Wish you and your family have a year of prosperity, happiness, and great success in the Year of the Dragon, and see you in the next video.